What is up, everyone? Welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are doing great today. Well, you guys, today is going to be a different video. It's not going to be a regular makeup tutorial as I usually do. Today, I am going to be showing you guys how to blow out your hair like a pro. The thing that I want to also show you guys in this video today is how to keep your hair straight for days without having to flat iron all those days. As for me, I usually tend to wash my hair once a week. I do have very thick hair, and this is my virgin hair. I have no color, no hair dye, and my hair was very, very short because in my pregnancy, I chopped the whole thing off, and now it's in the process of growing. It's been growing very healthy, and you know, I haven't been using too many expensive products. To be honest, I will be showing you the products that I've been using for my hair. But when I blow out my hair and I iron it just once, my hair will last straight for about 5 days. And if you guys stick around, you guys will learn the tricks that I do to keep my hair this way. So you guys stick around for this blowout tutorial and I will see you guys in a bit. All right, so like I said before, my hair is virgin. I have very healthy hair and I take very good care of it. Am I the one to be using a blower and flat iron almost every day? No, I just do my hair maybe like once or twice a month. That's how many times I do blow out my hair, and I flat iron it just once every time I blow it out. Now the rest of the time I usually have it curly. I usually use just regular cheap products that you could find in Walmart, and they are cheap but they are very good. And this is the shampoo and conditioner. This is Tresemme. The good thing about this shampoo and conditioner, it is a luxurious moisture, and I use it for dry to damaged hair. Even though my hair is not damaged, I still like to use this duo shampoo and conditioner just because I feel that it helps my hair stay nice and smooth every time I wash it. So for shampoo, I wash my hair twice, and then I condition and massage the conditioner for at least 1 minute towards my scalp to the ends, then rinse it. Afterwards, I will go to the next product. It is the Manoy Repairing Hair Mask. Now, this Manoy hair mask has helped my hair so much. It's just a rich and luxurious hair mask that helps my hair, and it has helped my hair twice in the process of it growing. What this does, it says it's a Manoy oil conditions, bamboo water strengthens, hydrolyzed silk and rebuilt. So it is a repairing hair mask. So the instructions say to apply to your hair wet, leave in hair for 5 to 7 minutes and rinse. Use a plastic cap and under a dryer for 10 to 15 minutes for a deep treatment. So you could also use this as a deep treatment for your hair. So I do have very thick hair and I have a lot of hair. So the process of me blowing it out takes a while and it takes a lot of effort and time. Now, if you want a perfect blowout, you guys have to have patience and just take some time, because I know people that just blow out their hair with the blower and they just go straight in with the flat iron. I like to give my hair a nice blowout, and you guys will see the results that I am not lying to you about how this is going to turn out. So of course, before blowing out my hair, I will grab a mist or anything to protect your hair from the heat. For today, I'm just going to use the She Moisture, and you could also find it, I believe, in Walmart or Walgreens. And this Hold and Shine Moisture Mist is for thick and curly hair, anti-frizz, moisture and shine. So it has coconut and hibiscus. That's what I use, just like whatever I can buy. I usually just apply it all over my hair before blowing it out. So that's the first step. All right, so now going into the blower. This blower is like my all-time favorite. First of all, it's lightweight. I mean, this is so comfortable to work with. This blower has made my life so much easier for me. This has been one of the best, and this is the Katana blower. I will leave the link down below where you could purchase it. I believe you can purchase it online, but this was, by that time, this was a total of $150, but this blower, you guys, it is life-changing and one of the best. Then I just grab a regular comb. I usually use a carbon comb to just have it ready for my flat iron. So what I do is I just comb out my hair. And the rest of the video will probably be a voiceover video because I cannot talk to you guys and, you know, do the blower at the same time. So what I'm going to do is just demonstrate to you guys how I part my hair and go directly with the blower. So the next thing that I grab, of course, is my brush from iTech. This is a metal brush with its bristles, but it's very good because it has a very good grab, and every time I'm going to blow out my hair, it grabs the hair and it keeps it firm on the brush. The thing about this brush is that it is metal, so it heats even more and it helps the process of drying quicker. So it has little holes in between, so that way the air from the blower will go in and dry up the hair even quicker. And as you can see, I am now parting down my hair. I can't see well in the back. So anyways, I just try my best to part it as I can. Then I'll just wrap it up with a scrunchie. You could also use a regular hair clip. All right, so you could either put the mouth, is what I call it, of the blower. You could either put it straight up, horizontal or vertical. In this case, I am going to leave it vertical so that way I could blow out my hair. As you can see, I am just drying a little bit the roots, and then I grab my brush and put the hair on the brush and just start grabbing the hair and drying it out. I'm pulling it, as you can see, and if you see the movement of my arm, then you can see that I'm just turning the brush as I go. So now I'm just going to part my hair again, and then I will grab the blower and do the same thing that I did on the bottom. As you can see, I'm just, you know, doing the best I can with that division that I'm making there. But anyways, as long as I blow everything out the same way and have everything just drying up, everything will be fine. As you can see, it's very important that you try to dry your roots. Do not put the blower towards your roots directly. I suggest you just put it like 2 inches away from your roots and dry them up a little bit. And then just when you grab the hair on the brush, there you go. Just put the blower towards the brush. And then you just keep on blow drying it. And as you can see, I am just repeating the same steps over and over. At this point, you could also turn the nozzle from the blower and you could put it horizontal. It'll probably be a little bit more comfortable. I mean, if you're not used to using it vertical like I am. But, you know, I didn't turn it just because, you know, I was a little lazy. I didn't want to just turn it constantly. So I just leave it like that. And it still blows out pretty well. All right, now I just part my hair to the side. And now I just grab the blower and start drying away. And are you guys seeing how red my face is? It is so hot. And then with the blower, oh my god, even hotter. And I didn't have any makeup on, you guys, because I was about to go to sleep. And I was not thinking about putting any makeup on. On the contrary, I had just washed my face. So I just had my night creams on. And right after this video, I was just going to go to bed. Alright guys, so now I just went ahead and zoomed in the camera for you guys so you can see a little bit better close up. And look at that blower. I mean, I slayed that blower. Look at that. I told you guys, no lie, no lie. Anyways, right now I'm just making a diagonal part for my hair. So that way, you know, it'll be a little easier for me because it's a little hard, you know, just going straight back because I can't see. So doing it this way, I can see towards the sides, and that way it's a little easier for me to blow out my hair. And this I wanted to show you guys. If you look closely, the brush is on top of my hair first and then beneath. So what I do on top is I grab it and just dry my roots a little bit. Then I go beneath and just pull the hair towards the sides and keep on blow drying the hair. I go above and beneath the hair. So however is more comfortable for you, but this way I feel like the blower is just very seamless and flawless. As you can tell, there are no hairs sticking up out of the roots. And I continue my journey. That little piece that's back there, I just part it, grab it, pull it back, and it's not too much hair, so it's a little easier for me to work with. I just go ahead and tie it, the rest of the hair, and work with that. All right, you guys, so then I just keep on going, doing the same steps, repeating them over and over. Pretty easy, isn't it? All right, guys, so now I have finally gotten to the crown area of my head. That means I am almost done. Hooray, hooray. That means it's a big relief for me. So anyways, you could do this either frontwards or towards the back. In this case, I decided to pull the hair towards the back and dry it. Alright, so this means that I only have two sections left, and now I'm just parting it in two, and I will do the back first and then I'll leave the front area for last. And this time I'm grabbing the brush and I am blow drying my hair towards the front, just pulling everything towards the front. This way, you know, when I'm going to style my hair, it'll look very pretty. All right, so last but not least, the front area of my hair. Just pulling it all towards the front. Blow drying it all towards the front. I always do this, even with my clients, unless, you know, they ask me to do the contrary, but I like to pull the hair towards the front because I believe, you know, the hairstyle will look way better. Oops, almost fell there.
All right, guys, so my hair is all blown out. Now, as for me, since I have so much hair and it's so much volume to it, I like it to look, for my personal opinion, I like it to look like more flat. Like I said before, I will only use the flat iron once and my hair will last at least for 5 days straight without having to retouch it with the flat iron or the blower. So this flat iron, I have had it for so many years. When you guys see it, you guys are gonna be like, is that supposed to be white? Well, I mean, you can tell, it's the love of my life. It's been with me through so many things, so many journeys. I just love it so, so much. And if something were to happen to this one, I think I would go to the end of the world just looking for another one, just like you. Anyways, you guys, this is my Nano Pro. This is from Hibari de Paris. That is the brand. This is a flat iron. I believe it is a titanium. I really forgot. It's been so many years that I don't even know if this is titanium or what. But anyways, I know that this is like my all-time favorite. And I do pump it up. I pump it up to 450. just because I only go over my hair like twice, depends, but you could do 4-10. It depends if you have like fragile hair, thin hair. If you have very thick hair, well then you can pump it up to 450. But it's not all the time recommendable that you do pump it up to 450. But since I protect my hair and this is what I use the Beyond the Zone. This is the Turn Up the Heat Flat Iron Protection. As you guys can see, this is what I use for my hair and I love this product so much. I just go ahead and spray it from far away and just open up the strands of my hair and just spray it through the ends. That way it'll be all prepped. So when I have to do the flat iron, so that's what I basically do. I usually just put it towards, you know, more towards the ends because I do not want my ends to just burn with the flat iron. So I tend to just focus on the ends. And I don't try to take it all the way to the roots, like I said, because I do not want my hair getting oily. But look at that, even just by applying that product, you could already tell how silky it looks without having to use the flat iron at all. If you like it like that with volume, you could go ahead and do you, but I'm not feeling it, girl. So I am going with my flat iron and then I will feel way better. So I'm just going to go ahead and do the voiceover once again so you guys can see the demonstration of how I flat iron my hair. I do use a carbon, I think it's like a carbon comb that really protects for the heat, and it when it goes through and you're gonna use a flat iron, it doesn't burn the comb, so the comb will stay intact with the iron in 450. All right, so at this point, I am just repeating the same steps that I did for the blowout. Just parting my hair and then grabbing the flat iron. And there you go. Pass it once or twice and that is it. You have to be careful that you do not burn yourself. I mean, it is the back part of the head, so I do it very carefully. All right, so now I'm at the side of the hair and I keep on parting it. And I just go through the hair, as you can see, once or twice, that is it. Now I'm finally at the front portion of the hair. Once I'm there, I start dividing my hair. And I grab the first area, the front area, where the bang is. And I just flat iron it towards the front. Then I like to connect the hair with the hair from the side. So the hair that's in the front, I connect it with the side. And everything else just goes towards the front. Alright guys, so this is the final look with the blower and the flat iron. So look at how it came out with the flat iron. I mean, I love how it looks this way. I really, really prefer doing the flat iron rather than just doing a blowout. So what I do now is apply glossing polish for their hair before the final step. Just take a little bit of glossing polish that you have for your hair on your hand and then just warm it up. What I like to do first is put it towards the rest of my hair, all of my hair. And the last part that I do are like the roots. This, you guys, is the final look for my blowout. And for the last and final step that you guys I know are waiting for. I mean, how does this girl keep her hair straight for so many days without having to flat iron her hair so many times or retouch her hair with a flat iron? The answer is in this little guy right here. It is my hair's best friend when my hair is straightened out. It's a little hair net. Now it does have like a strand, so it's a little tight. This goes tightly on your head so that way it could put the hair firmly and it will last for a few days. I mean, my few days are at least like 4 or 5 days, depending how greasy my hair is. And when I found out that these little things existed, girl, woo, these have been my hair's best friend, like I said. So how to use it? Simple and easy. Short, or long hair, it doesn't matter. The way to put it is simple. This is called like a wraparound. Now, I know it's a little hard for people to wrap their hair, but with this little guy, I will show you guys the easy way. All right, so you have like two options. You can either flip it this way, this way, you can start wrapping it up, or you can flip it this way. Whichever way suits you the best. I personally usually always flip my hair this way. Okay? All you have to do is put your hair to the side, open up the hairnet, and start putting it right there. And once you have it there, just all you have to do is start turning it. Just turning it around, taking your hand inside the net, accommodating the hair towards the direction you want your hairs to go. Then just keep on turning it, and you see how these hairs are already flipping upwards. And that is all you have to do. Simple as that. You could either tuck it behind your ear, or you could leave it in front of your ear, however works best for you. There you guys have it. This is my hairnet. This is what I use, and it's only one buck. So try it out, leave a comment down below. Tell me how it works for you. I hope you guys enjoyed today's tutorial. So you guys remember to subscribe to my channel before you leave and give this video a thumbs up. And remember always that your inner beauty is what truly reflects your outer beauty. I love you guys so much. Mwah. Till the next video.